crash that led to two arrests, but police made a disturbing discovery at the scene.
Yeah, two children, a four-year-old and an infant, were in that car. Now, we're happy to say they're okay, but tonight the woman arrested is out of jail on her own recognizance, and we're digging into why. According to Memphis police, the chain of events started Monday at Ridgeway and Mount Moriah when officers spotted a silver Kia speeding. Inside the vehicle were Latoya Jones, Dylan Yates, and the couple's two young children, a four-year-old girl and a seven-month-old boy. A check of the license showed the vehicle was registered to Jones, who also had an outstanding warrant for negligent homicide and aggravated child abuse under 8 years of age. Police lost track of the Kia, but say they soon found it in this parking lot on Hickory Hill Road, where the driver, Dylan Yates, refused to get out of the vehicle. Instead, investigators say he rammed a police car. The police narrative states that Yates led police on a chase that made its way to Kirby Parkway. From there, Yates allegedly ran several red lights, reaching speeds in excess of 65 miles an hour, before crashing near the intersection of Crumpler Road and Amberwood Drive. The vehicle flipped, but no one, including the children, were reported hurt. Investigators say Jones admitted the vehicle belonged to her and admitted telling Yates, quote, to keep driving because they did not do anything wrong. Jones and Yates were charged with child abuse and neglect. Yates was additionally charged with evading arrest. Court records showed Jones was released on her own recognizance. We went to the address listed for Jones, but were told she was not there. Now, Dylan Yates remains behind bars on a $50,000 bond. He's due in court on Thursday. We did reach out to pretrial services to see if they can tell us why Jones was released on her own recognizance, and we are still waiting to hear back.